There is a fifth dimension beyond that which is known to most managers. It is a dimension as vast as space and as timeless as infinity. It is the middle ground between art and science, between the qualitative and quantitative, and it lies between the pit of a manager's fears and the summit of their knowledge. That's the signpost up ahead. Your next stop, the Strategy Light Zone. The time, 5:30 p.m. The place, a company, any company, maybe yours. The situation, a working session between two managers preparing for tomorrow's strategic plan presentation. Does the critical success factor slide go before or after the SWOT analysis slide? Why do we even need a slide to include SWOT analysis? We didn't do anything with it. It's just a check the box exercise. It's part of the template deck, so it's got to be in there. But you're right, at this point, it's just a big laundry list. If anything, it shows that we're not very focused. How are the big rocks different from the strategic objectives? We have one slide with the rocks and one with the objectives. Hey, I know. We could put a rocks, paper, scissors animation into the slide to show that the big rocks win. Actually, paper covers rocks. We could make the strategic plan the paper that covers the big rocks. That doesn't make any sense. The big rocks are part of the strategic plan. Okay, so where is our strategy slide? Shouldn't we have a slide that clearly and concisely describes our strategy? You're right. We have 45 slides and not one shows our strategy. We've got the situation analysis, all the market share data, objectives, tactics, metrics, but no strategy. What should we do? Well, what would you do? For many well-intentioned managers, this episode of the Strategy Light Zone is all too real. Research published in the Harvard Business Review showed that 43% of managers couldn't state their own strategy, and 67% of managers believe their organization is bad at developing strategy. Both of these dismal numbers may be in part due to the fact that only 19% of managers say their companies have a distinct process for developing strategy. To avoid being forever trapped in the strategy light zone, you need three things. Number one, knowledge. At your next meeting, distribute a 3x5 note card to each person. Have them write down their definition of strategy on one side, and then one of their business strategies on the other side. Collect the note cards and begin by reading all of the definitions of strategy aloud. How many are identical? How many are even close? Then read the strategies. Are they really strategies? Or are they goals, tactics, and hopes masquerading as strategies? One of the primary reasons people can't state their own strategy is because they don't know what the word strategy means. Business strategy can be defined as the intelligent allocation of resources through a unique system of activity to achieve a goal. Once you've set your goals and objectives, strategy is how generally you're going to achieve them. Tactics are how specifically or tangibly you're going to achieve goals. The distinction between strategy and tactics was articulated even as far back as 2,500 years ago by Chinese general and philosopher Sun Tzu when he wrote, "All the men can see the tactics I use to conquer, but what none can see is the strategy out of which great victory is evolved." Number two, skills. Think about your organization. Are your managers operating at a high level when it comes to strategic thinking skills, such as making trade-offs, allocating resources, differentiating versus the competition, and creating innovative new value for customers? Remember that your organization's success or failure is a composite of your manager's strategies and the strategic thinking skills used to develop those strategies. If a manager's mindset is conditioned with constant firefighting, being reactive instead of proactive, and the inability to make trade-offs, then developing effective strategy is going to be a challenge. Great strategies come from great strategists. And just like great musicians, artists, and athletes, great managers are the ones who continually practice and hone their strategic thinking skills. Expertise in any domain is a result of deliberate practice, not natural-born talent and not luck. Attributing another's success to natural talent or luck are the excuses of those lacking the discipline to practice their craft and hone their skills. Number three, process. While the act of creating something new often comes in a flash of insight, the ability to conjure value from the insight generally requires a process. Great chefs experiment with ingredients and preparation methods, yet without a recipe or process, their meals wouldn't exist. A world-renowned architect like Frank Gehry explains, "What's exciting to me is the process. And when people look at the stuff because it looks like it just happened, they don't realize how much time and effort went into the incubation. So I'm always compelled to explain all that." While the insight behind your strategy may come in a flash of inspiration, the channeling of that insight into a well-conceived strategy and its successful execution is formed by process. There are 5 steps to a solid strategy process. Number 1, discovery, collecting intelligence on the market, customers, competitors, and the organization. Selecting a strategy team, completing the strategy survey to prepare the team for the next steps. Number 2, strategic thinking. Workshops to generate and share insights on the business that lead to new value for customers and competitive advantage for the company. Number 3, strategic planning. Channeling the strategic insights into an action plan to achieve the goals and objectives. Number 4, strategy rollout. Clearly communicating the strategies with all employees and translating those strategies and what they mean to them into their daily activities. And number 5, strategy tune-up. Periodic refreshing of the strategy using the chosen strategic thinking tools, comparing metrics to objectives to ensure the business is on course. 2 managers hold up in a third floor conference room the night before a strategic plan presentation. Will the plan be a useful tool to drive their activities throughout the year? Or is it simply another dog and pony show to appease senior management? Tonight's tale from the Strategy Light Zone. To explore more than 200 resources to develop your strategic thinking and planning capabilities, visit strategyskills.com.